Sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, please.
So, very good morning to all, to this very very interesting and vital seminar of the today. And at the outset, I welcome to the seminar to all the esteemed participants. There are many entrepreneurs, industry association representatives, startups, my CTTC colleagues, consultants, and technical agencies, and also a group of young executive management trainees from Hindalco. They are all here inside our campus for an executive development program. I welcome them. And they are also attending. They are very much interested to attend about this seminar. And I also welcome to Mr. A. Lasekar, our general manager of CTTC Bhubaneswar, who has taken the initiative to organize this event. Within a very short time, when we received the letter and we came to know, the biodegradable and compostable plastic bag technologies has been developed by DRDO, that advanced system laboratory of DRDO Hyderabad. And in fact, it is the need of the hour. As you know, sir, the CTTC Bhubaneswar is having WIPOTIST Technology Innovation Support Center under the World Intellectual Property Organization. It is one among 11 such centers in India. Also, we have the IPFC, Intellectual Property Facilitation Center. MSME CTTC Bhubaneswar is known as alternatively as MSME Technology Center. It is one of the leading performing technology center in the country under the Ministry of MSME. And under this WIPOTISC and IPFC, we provide various kinds of technologies development support services to the startups, MSMEs, and the research scholars. We provide also IP facilitation services such as patent filing, industrial design filing, trademark filing, copyright filing, GI filing, also market competitive intelligence analysis and active analysis kind of support services for their to support their projects and innovative ideas. And there are many such success stories. The support services provided by CTTC, some of the innovators, some of the startups, they have backed the award from Honorable Vice President of India. And some of them has also able to sign the MOU with the private angel investors, with other from Singapore and the USA. Like such, many such success stories are there. And as one of the initiative under the WIPOTISC IPFC and CTTC IPFC, also we support MSMEs and startups to make them aware about the innovative technologies which are the need of the hour, either the technology which are available at pre to operate, or the technology which are developed by like esteemed organizations like DRDO, or highly advanced and research centers like DRDO, Bhabha Atomic Research Center, ISRO, etc. We are coordinating, and sometimes we conduct similar kind of seminars. We facilitate, make the MSMEs, startups, and others aware about the technologies available and facilitate them to transfer this technology for the commercialization purpose. This is one of such initiatives today. We are organizing the seminar with the collaborative support of our technology partner, this program for this event on this biodegradable and compostable plastic bag technology, which has been developed. And here we have the speaker, Dr. Veera Brahmam, the scientist step. He's a very good scientist. He has got eminent profile, very hardcore knowledge. He is one of the innovative person behind this technology, leading person. Sir, thank you very much for accepting our request and accepting it quickly in spite of a very tight schedule to help us to organize this event for the benefit of the MSMEs, startups, and other interested stakeholders. With this, I request our general manager, Sri L. Lasekar sir, to kindly introduce, give a welcome address and introduce our the chief speaker of the event and the guest, Dr. K. Veera Brahmam sir. Sir, over to you, sir.
Sir, thank you, sir. Sir, on behalf of Team CTTC, I would like to welcome all the members, sir, who have been taken their time and joined in this particular meet. It's a great opportunity to thank Dr. Veera Brahmam sir, scientist staff. So it's before starting, I think people we should know about what he and all. And I'm very glad to invite Dr. Veera Brahmam sir, is a scientist staff, the person behind this R&D of this particular product. Today, sir is going to give you more details about. And without his hard work and effort, we could not able to achieve this product. and Dr. K. Veerabrahma did his MSc Physics and PhD from Sri Venkateswaran Institute Tirupati in the year 1997. And he is the gold medalist and university first ranker for the year 1997. And he did his PhD in the year 2004 from the same university on development of nano semiconductors for flat panel displays. And he joined in DRDO in the year 2002 and worked in the area of polymer composites, testing and optimization of the properties of a carbon epoxy and carbon phenolic composites. Sir is received a Scientist of the Year award from the National Environment Academy in the year 2014 and got Best Technical Paper Award in the year 2015 at Telford, London. He is the recipient of Commander-in-Chief Medal of Realization of Agni 3 Systems. And at present, he is the Deputy Project Director for Agni 3 Missile System. Sir, thank you for joining with us. We would like to wish to learn more from you, sir. My best wishes for other people who have been participated, and including my trainees, including my faculties, MSME industry associations and all. And I think we can continue with your presentation, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir, for your introduction. And we have very eminent and an expert resource person available today. He's a very hardcore scientist. And since this is a DRDO, is a Government of India and the Ministry of Defense program. And regarding details of the technologies and the modus operandi for this transportation, transferring to the MSMEs will be discussed by sir in due course of the time. As you know, the green and eco-friendly business is the need of the hour. Today's world, with the greatest challenge before us, that is sustainability and the waste disposal, which is the most competitive factors. Sustainable manufacturing is going to play a key role for survival and growth of the socio-economy. There is no doubt about it. And today's, in the technological world, we are talking about sustainable manufacturing. The creation of manufactured products that use processes and that minimize negative environmental impacts, conserve energy and natural resources, are safe for the employees, communities, and the consumers, and are economically sound. So evolution of sustainable manufacturing, it passes through the different phases, such as traditional manufacturing, lean manufacturing, green manufacturing, and sustainable manufacturing. So the green and sustainable manufacturing primarily includes 6 R principles, like reuse, recover, recycle, redesign, reduce, and remanufacture. So this is one of such initiatives. Today we are going to talk about this technology, availability of this technology, and the development of the technology, which is one among these 6 R components. So with this background note, I request Dr. K. Veerabrahma sir, as a scientist here from ASL Advanced System Laboratory of DRDO, who is the eminent scientist and expert in this technology, who is the man behind this technology development, to go ahead with this presentation, and further subsequently there will be discussion and interaction, any kind of the questions or query from the participant. I request you, sir, please go ahead, sir. Thank you, sir. Over to you, sir. Vibham, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I hope I am audible, and
yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Presentation is visible to everybody.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Good morning. In fact, indeed, I am very happy to share my research work with all the people, especially who are taking this work to the rural villages of the parts of the country. I am very glad to appreciate Mr. Dr. S. K. Kar as well as Rajshekar sir for taking this initiative to take this technology into rural parts of India, so that we can eradicate in future all polythene, and so that we can go for a biodegradable solution.
Okay, sir.
You please, all of you, note this. I am Dr. Veerabrahma, Advanced Systems Laboratory. This is my email and mobile number. Please note it down. If any doubts you have in future, you can contact me at any time. My sequence of presentation goes like this. I'll give first introduction, need for change of alternate solutions, technology used in DRDO and ecolastic product, salient features, what are the raw materials, how we made optimization of formulation, granule production, film making and blowing process, printing, and what are the QA aspects and SOP for storage and usage, final test reports. We know everybody, we are facing the entire country, not only country, entire globe is facing the first threat of the plastic. The human life majorly dependent on single-use plastic, especially like carry bags, water bottles, all these aspects. It looks very nicely. Usage is also very comfortable. But if you go, the degradation point of view, it takes minimum 200 to 400 years for complete degradation. So which is becoming a major threat, especially polyethylene and polypropylene and all of the polyethylene products or any plastic products causing a lot of environmental damage. Not only environmental damage, it is causing a lot of diseases, knowingly, unknowingly, to all the human beings also. The coming to the usage is one aspect. And another is, once we use it, simply we are throwing. The process of collection, segregation, and recycling is slightly, I feel myself, it is very poor in our country. So this is causing a major threat to our country in future. So as a result of that, the government, animals, ocean and land, all the things are polluted with the polyethylene, especially polyethylene and PP-based plastic products, which is causing dying of animals, fishes, and etc. That we are seeing day-to-day in newspapers and media. So there is a need to change from plastic era to biodegradable era. So for that, we have started the initiation of the thing.
Hello.
The government also has initiated making the single-use plastic banning, especially.
Hello.
The single-use plastic banning, when we do, basically, at a time, if we do the banning, then there are two implications will come. First is the customers will feel fatigued. The second is the MSME industries, which are producing now polyethylene bags and polyethylene products, they don't have next livelihood. They will become physically handicapped. So that is the reason when in the last meeting of NITI Aayog, when I was there, they have asked my suggestion. I told them, first, we'll show some alternate solution. Then we'll go for gradual removal of the polyethylene. We'll go for biodegradable solution. So that's the reason they have made a gradual change of polyethylene usage from 50 microns to 120 microns. Then next 1 or 2 years over the time, slowly they will completely ban the plastic products. So that's why government decided in a phased manner, they want to replace with a plastic products by biodegradable and compostable products. Coming to the technology that we used in the DRDO point of view, if you see, we have done identify the right and safe formulation using biomaterials related thing. We have not used any plastic content of materials. That if you see the worldwide scenario, if you come across now, many of the people will say biodegradable solution is there. But what is the problem is, you know, worldwide people are using polylactic acid based biodegradable bags. You know, polylactic acid, again, it has a life of 40 to 50 years. At the same time, it is not home compostable. It is industrial compostable. Again, we had to fill huge landfills we had to do for degradation of PLA. That's why we thought of that we can go for a product which is should be a home compostable, especially, and biodegradable. For that, we have selected basically the PBAT is one material and starch is another material. And other raw materials which are available in the country abundantly, those are the things we have selected. We made the formulation and we made the trials and we produced the bags also. So, once I made the formulation, I want to go for trials of making the bags. We have selected a company, Ecolastic Products, Hyderabad. And we made finally the realization of the product with a good R&D support from our side and realization support from the firm. That's the reason finally we are able to go for the production of this product with the alternate, which is an alternate to conventional single-use plastic, eco-friendly, do not contain conventional plastic, no harm to animals or aquatic life by disposal or consumption, which is biodegradable greater than 90% and compostable within the 90 days. It has good tensile and elongation properties, similar to polyethylene, but slightly 80% less than the elongation compared to polyethylene, and fully tested and certified for this. So we made the salient features of this product, especially if you see, biodegradable and compostable greater than 90%. Good tensile strength and elongation, 80% compared to polyethylene. Here I want to bring out one point to everybody. See, polyethylene will have a good elongation properties, but it has very poor biodegradability. Whereas if you go to biodegradability point of view, any material if you select, they will be having inferior properties, but biodegradability will be good. That's why you should compromise somewhere, strength as well as biodegradability. That is the way we made the formulation of this. The formulation we have selected in such a way that it does not have equal mechanical or tensile or elongation properties of our polyethylene. It will be 70% or 80% of polyethylene properties only will be there. But it has very good biodegradability and compostability. That's the basic features and added features of formulation what we developed in DRDO. So how the formulation what we developed is different with the existing biodegradable things. So many companies now selling we have biodegradable solution and all the things. But what way it is different to our product what we developed in DRDO. Many of the worldwide companies, if you see, they are making the PLA-based biocompostable solution. But, you know, that is having a life of 40 to 50 years, as well as, you know, you have the life of, and you need an industrial compostable solution of huge landfills for that thing. That's why we have selected PBAT with some additives. Then we are able to tune the biodegradability aspect by tuning my formulation. PBAT is one biopolymer we are using, as well as we are using starch, corn starch especially, because we have selected corn starch, which is abundantly available within India and abroad also. That's the reason we have selected this specifically PBAT plus additives of starch. So coming to the PLA base, it is industrial compostable, whereas our thing is home compostable. Cost also very low compared to PLA base, this thing. You know, PLA availability is not that much abundantly available compared to PBAT. Another important aspect I want to tell is why I have selected 90 days only the life for this carry bag. You know very well, when we use polyethylene bag, we will go for first usage, then we will fold it and we'll put in our home. Then that is causing a lot of pollution again. So we don't want to give any chance of storage of the any of the used, single-used plastic carry bag. That's why we have given life of 90 days. Some applications we are also give, anybody requires 6 months also life, anybody requires 1 year also life, we can give. That life we are able to tune and we can do the formulation based on the customer requirement again. So starch is the raw material and PBAT is the raw material, and these are the materials we are using and controlling the formulation so that we are able to give biodegradability greater than 90% within 60 days, and after 90 days, if we just throw this bag at any of the plant in soil, it will dissolve after 90 days. So we have developed two types of solutions. One is water soluble, another is water resistance. In water soluble, what we made is, being a DRDO, we are making this in the form of for naval application. where people will go onto the ship or deck, they will eat something and they will throw simply in the sea. Such a case, all polyethylene bags are again coming onto the shore and giving lot of pollution. That's why this solution, once they throw in sea, it will dissolve and fishes can eat this thing. Another one is the land application, that what I have just now discussing about this. This is for all carry bags we are going to give. See, basically we want to go for, first at present our intention is that carry bags we have to do, over the time we have to go for water bottles. So our some trials are going on to get required MFI for making the water bottles also. Once water bottles and carry bags have been done for replacement, I hope 60% of pollution we can avoid on the globe and the country. So, you know, every entrepreneur who is seeing here, they may be knowing how to make a carry bag is, they have only three equipment required. The number one is, you know, extruder for making the granules or compounding. And another one is, you need a blow equipment. This is a granule making point of the extruder. Then another one is blow equipment. You want to make a film means, you take the granules, melt it and blow it into the required height of the hull. And after that, you can go ahead with whatever the size of the bag you want. You can just change the die, whatever you want it there. Then you can produce big bags, especially for small size of the bags too. Up to garbage bags also can able to produce this. We have done the testing and with the thing. The advantage of this is, you know, there is no thickness limitation. Whereas if you come to polyethylene, you have to make now 120 microns thickness. But in biodegradable solution, there is no such thickness limitation. Any thickness you can produce based on your application. You need more strength aspect, means slightly thickness you should increase. Little strength for a small vegetable carrying and all small bags point of view, 20 to 30 microns also sufficient. Printing, you know, rotograve machine, where you can go for this printing aspect. In the printer also, when we use the pink print ink, we use again the food graded ink only. So we can say that the product which we made is 100% no plastic content. Now coming to entrepreneur's point of view, cost of equipment details, I want to give it to you. See, there are two aspects we are going. Number one is the extruder, blow equipment, printer. Suppose you want entire setup, you want to make it, 2 to 3 crores it will happen. So this making the granule point of view, we want to give technology transfer to the companies on free of cost we are giving. So we are not charging any free of cost, but 2% on net sales, we are charging the royalty on the net sales of the what company has sold. We go another important aspect. Suppose somebody, they don't have capacity to go for granule making. Then they can procure the granules from Ecolastic Products, Hyderabad. We have the huge setup for giving the granules to the small companies. If they give what is the amount of quantity of granules required, then we are able to give it comfortably to them. If they write letter to me, I will recommend it. Then they will give the granules to them. In such case, there is no requirement of extruder. They need only blow equipment and printer. The cost is approximately 60 lakhs. So if anybody want to go for granule making, they want to take technology from DRDO, one mandatory is that they must have quality control lab. See, QC lab is the must. It will be approximately the costing 20 lakhs. Why we are doing is that, once we give the technology transfer, if you don't maintain the quality, then people may blame that DRDO has not given good technology. But that is not the fault of DRDO technology, that's the fault of person who is making the bags. That we want to avoid it. That's the reason anybody want a technology transfer for making the granules, they must and should have the QC lab, then only we'll give the technology transfer to them. So these are the bags of different sizes what we made at our laboratory. And in a company now, we have producer list. Now, coming to one important aspect you can come across. Many people may think that where is the market? This is one point I want to tell to you. Now, many of the people got a lot of awareness and they have in their minds, they don't want to use plastic, but they don't have alternate solution. That's why people are habituated to use polyethylene. Suppose if you give this solution, even 1 rupee cost high also, people are ready to give and take this type of solution. They never use polyethylene-based bags or something. Because I'll tell you one simple thing. First, we have done the production and we are given at Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam, Tirupati, for distribution of prasadam or laddu. We have taken the feedback from the customer. What customer is saying simply that, sir, if even 2 rupees, we are giving for 3 rupees one bag. They are telling even 5 rupees also, we don't have any problem, we'll pay because we don't want to use polyethylene bag. Means now people and got lot of awareness that they can go for even 1 rupee, 2 rupees extra also, no problem. They will take biodegradable bag instead of polyethylene bag. That's why I don't think that market is not there. I don't feel it. Only thing is we have to tell them, we have to educate them. This is useful in this way compared to this. Coming to technology transfer issue, technology transfer fees is nil. We are not charging anything. But we are charging net on net sales 2% royalty. This money will go to Ministry of Defense. If anybody want to do export also, no problem. After they obtain permission from us, they can go for export of the product also. There is no issue. Initially, we are giving 10 years license. After 10 years license, again, we will go for renewal of the license for technology transfer. Then they can use DRDO emblem also wherever they are selling so that they can get good brand value for marketing also. Then I told you already QA policy. Okay. Any technology transfer you want to give means they should meet the quality assurance and quality control plan, which we will give in the technology transfer document at the time of TOT transfer. Suppose somebody is not maintaining the quality and all the things, then we may cancel the license at any point of time. Suppose any new firms they want to establish, then we'll give the entire technology transfer document to them. As per that, we'll give the machinery, we'll give the raw material details and where the machinery is available, where the raw materials are available. Entire document I will be giving in the next month to all the entrepreneurs who are coming for a new setup of making this production of the bags. So they need infrastructure, they need QC lab for requirement to meet. And another important aspect is to whom we want to give technology transfer, we'll give. They have to show the company, a DRDO committee will come and see the company. If we feel happy, we'll give the technology transfer immediately to them. Suppose somebody want to go for only granules, they want to make the bags, then just write a letter to me for this mail address, then we will give it. The granule cost at present is 2.30 lakhs per ton. We are charging for biodegradable case. Now coming to machinery details. Extruder cost, approximately it will be 166 lakhs. Blow equipment, you may be knowing, 24 lakhs. Printer around 29 lakhs. Bottom sealing and depunching equipment around 37 lakhs. Along with this equipment, you know, you may need transformer and chiller. That will be around 44 lakhs. Totally costing around 3 lakhs to entire setup of this with zero fees of technology transfer. This value I am giving for extruder of 500 tons per month, blow equipment 150 tons per 12 hours, printer 1 ton per 12 hours. The power requirement is, see, if you run the system equipment, 3 shifts, 2 shifts, 1 shift. Now at present, this company is running 3 shifts. Yes? If you go for 2 shifts, around 250 tons, you can go for a month. It will be around 7,000 units. It will be used. It will be current charge will come. Coming to size of the building, 25 feet height is the must. If you go for two shifts, 14 members is required. If one shift, 7 members is sufficient. I advise that minimum half acre is there, land. It will be better to set up entire thing, including future expansion also. Coming to QC and QA of the product. So once the product is produced, you have to go for quality control. The quality control point of view, you need a setup of moisture measurement content, viscosity content, ash content measurement, all these equipments. On raw materials level, in process parameters at granules level, and final product level. So these are the checks we have to do for maintaining the quality of the product. Coming to cost, see, generally everybody will be having one doubt on this, is that, you know, I am trying to give a comparison picture of 50 microns, 50 microns, 120 microns. See, now polyethylene 50 microns is not there, means center column is not there now. Now only 120 microns column only will be there in coming just future. So if you make a polyethylene of 50 microns thickness, definitely 50 micron thickness of polyethylene is low cost compared to biodegradable one of 50 microns thickness. But now, as per the new Government of India amended rules, you know very well that now 120 micron thickness of polyethylene only, they have to sell it in future. Then if you compare the cost, approximately 30 to 40% of profit will get it. So that's the reason. Now, whatever the solution we are giving is economically viable as well as is a futuristic technology which is going to be used for the benefit of the country, for the mankind, and for the benefit of the society. So there are another important aspect come to everybody. Suppose I made some bags. It has degradability, biodegradability is there. Then how many days I can store with me in a kirana shop or any of the shop? So simple, whatever the size of the bag you make it, whatever the size you make it, it has the life of 6 months. Let us suppose you kept it in a kirana shop, 500 bags, then we'll give you a sealed condition, you have to keep it. As soon as you don't open the seal, nothing will happen to the bags. So 6 months it can be used happily. Because in a kirana shop, within a day, all 5,000 bags, nobody will take. That's why we will give one by one slowly over the time. See, I tell this point very clearly. Everybody, please keep this point in your mind. Once you remove the bag from the container, then if you keep it at open atmospheric condition continuously, after 60 days, it will lose its strength. If I just tear it off, it will break into pieces. Means in aerobic condition, in ambient condition, if I put in open atmospheric exposure condition, 60 days is the life. It will lose its strength. Suppose if I throw this at plants, it will dissolve in soil in 90 days. It does not mean that after 60 days, once I from the date of production, after 60 days, it cannot be useful. No. Once you keep it outside, individually the bag, then it will expose very high to moisture. Since it has a starch content, it will undergo biodegradability because of microbial activity. That's why we are giving what are the storage condition, transportation conditions, and how you will use the bag within 60 days. All those things we'll give in a technology transfer document where the people can utilize comfortably. So thank you very much for giving the opportunity, for giving all the details about the product. Now, anybody is having any of the query, you please ask me.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Biraramam. That is a nice technical input, and you have provided the information. I could see a couple of questions in the chat box. Okay. I'd like to spell out here so that you can reply to them. Maybe some of them could not able to, like there's a question from Mr. Mohan that they could able to understand what is PLA based and PBAT, full form and meaning. Because
PLA is polylactic acid. PBAT is polybutylene adipate tetrapalate.
Okay, there is another question from Samira, ma'am, from Town Impact. It's a technical agency. What does 120 thickness help? And can you get some more details on the machinery and the brief machinery details has been already
Machinery and raw material.
Okay, yes, please.
No, we are making one technology transfer document completely. Right. In the technology transfer document, what are the raw materials will be used? What are their specifications? Where it is available? Entire information we are furnishing in a small book. To whom they are going to make the granules, we'll give, once we will have an agreement with the DRDO. Once the agreement is over, immediately we'll give the document to them. And coming to machinery point of view, I am going to share the machinery details to all the MSMEs within 10-15 days. Why I am taking this time is, see, there are different types of equipments are available in the country abroad from China or European countries and all the things. There are some machineries coming from local Indian market also, like Gujarat or Chennai or some other places which is coming. So I'm trying to consolidate the machineries which are useful. Because suppose if I say, X fellow, you go there and purchase. Then after going there by taking this equipment, suppose you are not able to get it. Then you may say that the DRDO person told this, I went to this company, then this equipment is not working like that. That's why now we are consolidating which are the firms based on their technical specifications of the machines. We are sorting out the company names for each item. Then soon I will distribute this to all MSMEs so that they can distribute to your respective entrepreneurs.
And it is followed by another question from the same, that is the QC lab mandatory for the companies making only bags and not the granules?
No. QC lab only mandatory for granule making people, but QC lab total lab may not be required for bag making people. They may be required only one equipment, that is tensile test equipment. The reason I'll tell you why they had to go for elongation testing in a batch level is, see, once bag is produced, they should know that whether they produce it properly or not and check proper strength or not. As per my knowledge, they need only one equipment. That may be the tensile equipment for bag making people.
Right. And then the question regarding the from Mr. Balasubramanian, what is the cost of this bag? And also with respect to that, there is another question in the chat box. Cost of the product as compared to availability of the products.
Yeah, coming to the point. So if you go for any shopping mall, what are the size of the bag? You may not be know, I may not be know, because there are different sizes of bags. If we take 13 to 10, 13 inches into 10 inches thing, approximately 3 rupees will come. So if you go for same thing in the market, they are a polyethylene based thing, they are selling knowingly, unknowingly to you for 5 rupees. So the cost of this bag is comparatively with polyethylene very cheaper. There is no doubt about it. Only thing is, for time being, you should aware the people, make awareness of the people that this is a biodegradable, this is normal for you.
Okay, there is a next question from Mr. Ashish Das. Sir, there are some other companies in market who are also selling biodegradable plastics. What will be our competitive advantage over them by using this technology?
So there are many companies making biodegradable bags and biodegradable products like that they are selling. See, basically what is happening, many of the companies in India, they are making with polylactic acid. The polylactic acid has a shelf life of around 40 to 50 years. So that is basically the big, again, one more problem in future is that, again, a product which is single-use product, if you are throwing on road, for again to get the degradability, it needs 40 to 50 years, let it at least 30 years. This is one drawback. Second drawback is, polylactic acid based bio polymer bags, if you take it, it will be cost more than the cost of what we have developed it. Same 3 rupees one will come in PLA base for 5 rupees. Second, We want to go for, see, whatever the bag we have, if you just throw at a plant in your home or with food waste, simply it will go along with that, it will go microbial activity and it will be undergone compostable and it turn into manure. But PLA based, you can't just throw it on road. You have to dig it and you have to fill in a landfilling, you have to do it. That's the difference of that. Second, one more thing. Especially my concentration is cost cutting only. I did the same thing. In the cost cutting point of view, we have loaded more starch so that it will be easily available to a common man who is sitting in the village. That's why the cost of existing PLA based companies, how many comes? Don't worry, the cost of this product will be lower compared to them.
There is a question from Mr. Mohan. Any industry using this newly developed technology by DRDO? Can you please get the reference? Yeah.
You know, Varina, last month only we have done it. This, all the things and publicity in Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam. Till now, we got around 500 applications for a technology transfer. Big companies, small companies, like that. Now, our main intention of organizing this MSME thing is also the same. We want to give the technology on free of cost to many of the companies so that they can spread this technology. So now, by end of November, we are giving to more or less 5,000 companies the technology transfer. So it is going to be massively spread within a span of 1 month. That's our aim of this thing.
Sorry, sir, interfere kar raha hu.
Sir,
we are existing manufacturer. Sir, can we use our existing machine for making biodegradable, sir?
Very good question. See, when I developed the solution of this technology, I have kept three of the things in my mind. Number one, if I give a new technology, you know, people have to go for a lot of changes in the existing machinery so that they have to go for production. Means all small scale industries, they have to afford a lot of money. That's why whatever the formulation we are given to you now, whatever the existing machine of polyethylene producing bags, without any changes, you can go ahead for production. Only temperature something, only at height of the blowing length and all the things only had to change. The remaining setup is same. That's the advantage of this technology.
Thank you, sir.
There's a question in the chat. Is DRDO producing these bags?
No. See, I want to tell you, I'm a basically missile man. So when we are working on the some structures, then I saw all animals and all the aquatic life dying in the media and newspaper in front of me also. That made me to go for one formulation making and all the things. See, DRDO is having a lot of work, other different works. So we have developed a formulation, we have given to some company, we have done it. Now we are giving all of you who are coming forward. Then it will automatically spread to entire country. No need, DRDO, no need to produce this product. In India, a lot of companies are there. You are all there. That's why we are giving to you on free of cost.
So there is a question. When will we be expecting a hands-on experience of this product?
Already it is there in the market. Already it is there in the market. Maybe it may take some time, maybe 2 to 3 months to come into the entire country. Because once these companies will come, after November end onwards, many people will start producing these bags. See, you know, it's a technology cycle curve. Initially, it will take some time. Once it picked up some time, then automatically it will go into spread over. I am expecting by December end, many of the companies may start production.
There is a question from Mr. Sanjay Patnaik. He is an entrepreneur. Will this product replace the nursery bags largely required by the forest and horticulture departments?
Yes. Whatever, basically, whatever the horticulture and whatever the bags you are using, you can use these bags also happily.
Mr. Rukman Gada, there is a question. Can we use any other agro waste other than the corn starch?
No. This formulation we made especially keeping in mind of our large usage of the bags. See, if you go other starch and whatever may be, it is very limitedly available within the country. See, to meet 120 crores of people of carry bags, you know, any non-available thing, if I select it, it is very difficult to meet the requirements. That's why we saw that corn is the highest production and within the country and across the globe. That's why we have selected corn starch is the basic raw material for this production. So other starches also you can use it, but limited quantity only you can able to produce. You can't produce tons of usage meeting to country like India, big population.
Okay, there is a question from Mr. Vikas Chaudhary. Is this material safe on food?
Safe?
Is this material safe for food?
Carrying food?
Food, yes. Contract.
Carrying food? Can you, yes, can you repeat for, the question, please?
Any kind of free from any kind of contamination bags.
The entire bag can be eatable, edible. So no problem to carry the food.
Oh,
it's an edible bag.
Okay.
Because all it contains only biopolymer. It does not contain any plastic. So there is no issue at all. But only one problem is there, you can't carry liquid. Why the reason? I'll tell you. You know, starch is having, when I add the ingredient of starch, starch will give light porosity.
Mm-hmm.
That's why when you pour liquid, it may give some diffusion out. But food you can happily carry. There is nothing.
Yeah, there is a question from Mr. G. Ramachandran. He is also a big entrepreneur. He is having the units in Hyderabad and Gujarat in many other places. He is a very matured and experienced entrepreneur. He likes to know, is there any study done on the permeability?
Yes, it's a good question. We are on the process of that because we want to make this for next coming milk package, milk packets packaging and all the things. We are doing on the job. But this formulation, as it is, you can't use it. We are doing some modification in the formulation for milk and liquid packaging point of view. Soon we are going to give it.
That means the technology is still in the process of further development.
Yeah. Because there you had to know OTDR and WTR tests we have to do it. That we are under the process of doing that.
I think that's quite good. Very good interaction, many interesting questions from the different participants.
Yeah,
if anybody is having any other thing to discuss, they can unmute themselves and put their question, or can discuss, or can send in the chat box before you close this meeting.
Sir, Samira this side. There was only one query, one curiosity point of view. So in that presentation, it was mentioned that the thickness has been increased from 50 to 120. So I just wanted to know what's the reason for that.
No, ma'am. You know, polyethylene, what happening, you know, when we, you know, previously the government of India rule is 50 microns thickness.
Huh?
But, you know, in our country, I'm telling openly, the controlling of this enforcement is not that much easy. Because
yeah,
some people who are just producing without a name and something, na? And what is happening? They are producing 20 microns thickness. So
okay,
if the government is giving 50 microns, but they are producing 20 micron thickness. The problem, what will happen, you know, when you produce 20 micron thickness, if it is used for any chemicals or any other things, you know, then it will contaminate. If thickness is more, easy to do recycling. If thickness is less, difficult to do recycling.
Okay.
That too, 20 micron thickness, again they will add some pigments for color point of view and all the things.
Yes, yes.
These are all causing 50 microns thickness itself is very difficult to do recycling. That without enforcement, some people do malpracticing of making 20 microns for getting more profit, further very difficult to do recycling. That's
right,
why recently
right.
Government of India taken a stringent rule that no 50, again they have to go 120 microns.
120, okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
For easy recyclability point of view, this rule they have imposed.
Yeah, understood. Yeah, thank you.
Sir, this side, Rukmangad Das.
Yes.
Sir, you said we can use other starch products, but not corn is available in plenty. Sir, in Odisha, we have a small problem that corn is not that abundantly available in Odisha.
I want to tell one point. Don't take only Odisha what is available. I have taken entire country across which is hugely available is corn. You don't worry. In Odisha, not available, no problem. In other places, it is available. You can take it from it. If you go Punjab, if you go other Karnataka,
sir, actually the cost of production will increase. That is what
I am telling this, including everything, is the cost is 30-40% profit you will get.
Okay.
Don't worry. You will get that raw material to your company directly. They will send it directly to your place with the same cost.
Okay, sir. So, thank you so much.
Hello, sir.
Sir, hello, sir.
Yeah, please.
I'm Aru. So, regarding the cost that you have mentioned, I am looking at the feasibility of setting up micro granulation and micro bag production units. So, do you think at the cost that you mentioned, it would be feasible for micro production units?
Yes, yes. It is feasible. That's why whoever can produce, you will get straight away 20-30% profit. Is the micro or macro is not an issue at all.
Okay, sir.
So you will get happily 20% is minimum pakka. More than 20, you will get a suppose example. I'll tell you. So if you tap a specific market, example like you take Flipkart, you take any shopping malls specifically. There, you know, knowingly, unknowingly, they will put more charge to you for a carry bag. Do you know? When yes, you go to some shopping mall, they will simply, you want a bag, they will ask you. Yes, you will tell. Implicitly, they will put 10 rupees or 15 rupees, they will give a bag to you.
Yes, sir.
So, it is not a question of this thing. See, how you tap the market, number one. Number two is, how much extent you are going to send it to the market. That's a simple logic of this. Profit is always depends upon not only production, no? It is a marketing dependent. Is it or not?
Yes, sir, it is.
That's the reason for timing, when you make the bags, you tap a market where a solid requirement is there, then you'll get a huge profit. Then over time, you can spread it over whatever the places you want.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, myself, Arun Naik from Odisha University of Agriculture. Sir, I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Please tell me. Sir, actually, I want to know if we add some nanoparticles like nano zinc or nano silver while making this biodegradable film, will it be advantageous to us and which way it will be benefited?
Why you are adding nano silica? Any specific reason?
Nano silver or nano zinc? Nano silver has some antimicrobial property. We are thinking to use it in food storage structure. Like that, we are working on that. Just we have initiated the work.
So, amazed, you want to use carry bags for food storage?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. Why you are using for food storage carry bags? Any specific reason?
Specific reason that we have the same objective. We want to eliminate the polyethylene bags and this biodegradable film bag with some antimicrobial property will be added. Then we can
You think one point very clearly. See, anybody carry in the bag some food, he will just take for a small fraction of time. Nobody will put food in the carry bag for long duration of time as per my knowledge concerned. Just they will carry to the home maximum, maybe 10 kilometers, 20 kilometers maximum you take.
Yes, that is the aspect of carrying actually. If we store it with a wrapping material like that, Our intention is that.
See, single-use plastic or single-use whatever bioplastic product we are using, very simple logic that we are carrying purpose only, we'll use it, correct?
Yes.
So, when I'm carrying, even you take biodegradable bag also, you put something, you carry it. Then after that, anyhow, you will take it and you will put in a vessel in your home. Within that short time of exposure, nothing will happen.
Yes, sir. But for a long period storage, we want to have a nano compounded film. Our purpose is that. So I want to know if we add that nano zinc or nano silver to that, we'll get some more benefit.
You you do one thing. Can you just come separately so that we can discuss your problem?
Yes, yes, sir. Right. Definitely. I don't have any problem.
If you are able to come to Hyderabad, you can come.
Yes, yes.
Then I can help you. There is no doubt about
it. Yes, sir. I need the attention. I have noted down your email.
Please. After 18th, you can come. Because next week, I am out of station.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You most welcome. You can come. I can definitely help you.
Thank you, sir.
Is there any company using this technology, sir, at present?
Already, Tirumal Tirupati Devasthanam, they are using, and Mrs. Ecolastic product, they are producing 3 sets.
Sir, they are producing?
Yes.
Okay. No, whether I can buy in bulk from them?
Happily, you can take, you write a letter to me for granules point of view.
Okay.
I will recommend how much tonnage you require per month.
Sir, it's not granules, it's the bag, final bag.
Bag you want it. Okay. Yeah. Bag you want, it means you give the size of the bag.
Okay.
And how much thickness is required. That's all.
To you, sir, can I contact?
You write a letter to me directly. Okay, these many bags per month is required. Okay. We are giving already, Bala.
Yes,
sir. We are giving already to Singareni colleagues. Before mining people, we are already giving per day 20,000 bags.
Okay.
So no problem. Bags also you can take it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
There is no problem.
Am I admitted, sir? I am from Bihar in the south. So I want to know, sir, are you using any type of your plasticizer?
Your voice is not clear.
Any type of plasticizer you are using? My question is, are you using any type of plasticizer for making this film apart from your PBAT and the starch? Any plasticizer being used?
Yeah, we had to use, sure. We are using Sorbital. Flow property, yeah. We will give some addition of the Sorbital, but it's a food graded only. Nothing will happen.
How to bring level up of how much, percentage-wise?
At present, we are not giving the technology of mixing and all the things. We are under the process of patent application. By next month end, we will give all the formulation details and everything to everybody. Don't worry. Okay?
Just wait. Can I get it?
Your voice is not clear. Can you?
PBAT supplier. I just want to know.
PBAT, at present, PBAT we are importing only. That's the only imported component. Now, DRDO is establishing some companies, to go for PBAT production.
Unauthorized construction on railway place, railway plot, on the railway place.
Hello. Dr. Kar.
No, somebody was mentioning, I think.
Some question is not clear, Dr. Kar. Can you just repeat me?
Hello.
No, yeah, please. Somebody was. Yes, please. Please ask, sir.
Hello.
Yes, please, audible, sir.
Yes, it is audible for me. Please tell me.
Actually, this printing needs corona treatment or not? Hello.
Dr. Kar, can you explain this question to me?
I think Mr. Pinaki Patnaik, I think he's raising a question, something relating to the, does it require any kind of treatment, corona treatment?
For printing.
For the printing.
Not required.
Not required, no? Okay.
See, corona, that point I don't want to discuss. There's a long, lengthy discussion. From a point of view, as per my understanding, in the world, there is no functionalization coating. Any surface can adhere, any surface can go off with the virus. No virus
not
can
virus,
stand.
Not virus, no, actually.
Same thing. Go for any of the cover on the surface. There is no need to give any coating, especially specific to virus.
Mm. It is for printing. But on PE, printing is a difficult thing. So in film, they used to give a corona treatment, heat treatment like that.
So for printing purpose, because it is on polyethylene, printing is not, the inks is not stick to the printing air. But in this biodegradable air, it need not require that treatment for printing. What I hope.
I'm not aware of this.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have a follow-up question. So like if we increase the width of the plastics, would we be able to create standard plastic bags which would be thicker? And if so, would we be able to use for storage for longer duration? And would it affect the degradable factor? If so, by how much?
This is like this, you know, especially for time being, we have made a formulation of 90 days.
Okay, sir.
If you require for any other application, I told in my presentation, if you have any application specific, you want a slightly more duration of time of life or biodegradability, that we can tune it. It's not an issue. But specifically for these normal applications where to carry something, that purpose only, at present we made the technology and ready to give it, because this is general purpose, carrying purpose of carry bags point of view, made this. Suppose some specific application somewhere I want to know, I want not 90 days, I want 6 months life, means we can give it, this part of it.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir.
Any more questions? You can take a couple of questions, otherwise you can close.
No issue. Please.
Yeah.
Good call, eh?
We are listening, sir. Please tell me. Hello.
Yes, please.
We are listening. Please tell me the question. Okay, Dr. Kar, any other points?
No, I don't think. I think only that was, there is no other question as of now. In fact, we have shared the YouTube link. Anybody is interested to watch it further, they can watch, and the details of contact, Dr. Birbhraman sir already he has shared, and you can contact with him. And we are also planning a kind of a detailed physical interaction WhatsApp in Bhubaneswar in near future, once little pandemic is a little over. And regarding this technology transfer, any of the entrepreneurs, those who are interested, you can be also directly either contact.
I want to tell one point, Dr. Yeah. You take all the applications who are coming for technology transfer, you please collect yourself and send it as a bunch at a time to me.
That is what we will also...
That will help me to reduce my work. Secondly, if anybody wants directly to write me, there is no issue. But if you collect and if you send it to me, it will be good so that I can give communication to you back.
Yes. So they can also come to us and we can also help them to reach to you and then we can connect you. And we can also help them in the process of establishing this setup. Maybe also we can link it to, if anybody is going to set up this unit, we can link it to our CLSTUS scheme of the ministry. So in terms of the getting some grants or some kind of subsidy, maybe that all this scheme can be connected, that we can explore these possibilities.
This is one point I want to tell. Some MSME companies, they are requesting, saying that, sir, we are taking your technology point of view. Can you give one letter?
Can you?
So we will give letter, no problem, to go for company establishment, something they are asking.
Yes.
But that also there is no issue. We will give you a letter saying that under the process of technology transfer, subjective to so-and-so conditions.
Sir, what it will be, the cost will be, sir, actually?
Which one?
Cost of this particular, like, you know, if you want to establish a particular...
I told you, no, already. 3 crores for entire setup.
Okay.
Maybe for only printing of the bags, so 60 lakhs is sufficient.
60 lakhs is sufficient.
You can, if you want, you can arrange any physical thing also. I'll come one day.
That will be nice of you, sir.
Most
a lot of industries, a lot of entrepreneurs are really interested. But like, you know, in a virtual, okay, fine, you try to explain as much as. But physically also, we can explain them and we can get in a confidence. What will be the demand in the market?
Sure. I think now you can arrange any day. There is no problem. Better put on Saturday.
Okay, no, that's good, sir. Sir, because we work for 7 days a week, sir, actually.
Yeah, no issue. Because why? Because Saturday means I may not have any problem. There is no problem. I'll come. There is no issue.
Okay.
And even, sir, also, there is another possibility. You can pass on this message to the corporate sectors. Those who will be interested also to set up the units in that
already community. Already gone. See, Niti Aayog has given a letter to 65 ministries, Government of India.
Sir.
65 ministries in the country. For promoting this product. I have every day minimum 5 to 6 meetings.
Okay.
So I'm pushing this to entire country. That's what my
main... No, that's great, sir, actually. Yeah, sir. I mean, in fact, we also look into this. Sir, what is the space?
It is that I hope partly that greatness goes to you only because you people, once you start doing this thing, means we are most happy because... Through MSMEs only can penetrate to rural level. That's what my personal opinion. So I am very thankful for your lot of initiation and for making this webinar. And I am very happy and I definitely congratulate and appreciate your efforts.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your time.
Thank you very
much. My sincere thanks to all the participants.
Sir, Asakar sir, we also find there is a possibility since we do a lot of work in collaboration with other countries, other developing countries like Zimbabwe, Myanmar, Kazakhstan, Sri Lanka, other things.
Yes,
will there be any issues? Suppose we organize a kind of international level seminar also.
That we can touch with the embassies also, sir. Already we have a good connectivity to more than 52 embassies. So our ambassadors also in a connect actually. Probably that we can percolate.
They will connect with us connected. That's nice.
Sir, can we do one experience center at in center in our center actually where 60 to 70 lakhs we can invest absolutely because people feel factor has to be there actually the technology what will happen you know like when we initiated
on
the oxygen concentrator now so everybody talks about the technology and all but what we done we have developed a proto we got in a confidence now commercial we are doing commercialization now that's like you know we are also interested to transfer the technology to the MSM. Already we have done 2 technology transfers, sir. Similarly, here also, because 60 lakh investment we can do from our ministry with a CSR initiative, so that we can percolate to the MSMEs. MSME, we can demonstrate confidently, actually. Understand, sir?
Sir, I will tell you one thing. If you are able to establish the setup for your demo point of view, whenever granules required, we will give free of cost. Don't worry.
Okay, that's great, sir. That's great. Then we will be sure. We'll immediately touch with you, sir.
Please.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, Kargar. And Rashekar.
Thank you, sir.
Namaste, sir.
I request you, please penetrate to the benefit of the country. There's only a point I want to tell this. Thank you for all the audience who are there in the webinar. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Take care. Bye.
Okay. Thank you, all the esteemed participants and from the entrepreneurs, industry association representatives, and other organizations, startups, technical agencies. We are really very much grateful to make this seminar a grand success today. And please be in touch with us in case of any kind of requirement relating to this or any other field. We'll try our best to help you. And EIDO is our definite knowledge partner, and we are a trusted partner of the country. In many of the technologies, and Viravarman sir is a very good scientist and he is an Agni man, missile man. He's working a lot of contribution in Agni Missile 3 project. Sir, we are really very much fortunate today to have you in this platform and to organize and make this event success. Thank you, namaskar, and have a good day.
Thank you, Dr. Kar, sir, organizing this program so successful. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. So with this, we take leave.
Okay, sir. Okay. Bye.
Thank you very much.
Bye, sir. Take care.